Good morning. Welcome to St. Brendan-on-the-Lake Parish, and a special welcome to any visitors who may be here today. I'm Monica Rowland, and I was chosen to proclaim the readings today. And today we celebrate the 30th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Announcements, just a few. There will be Eucharistic Adoration on Monday in Newfane from 4 to 7. Mass for All Saints Day, a holy day of obligation, will be held this Tuesday, October 31st at 7 p.m. in Newfane, and on Wednesday, November 1st at 8:30 a.m. in Wilson. And there will be a special Mass for All Souls on Thursday, November 2nd. We will pray for this past year's dearly beloved loved ones from St. Brendan's. And our celebrant today is Father Matt.
Our opening hymn this morning, number 537, Sing a New Song, number 537. Please rise.
Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Rise, O children, from your sleep. Your Savior now has come. He has turned your sorrows to joy and filled your soul with song. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Glad my soul, for I have seen the glory of the Lord. The trumpet sounds, the dead shall be raised. I know my Savior lives. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia, singing Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And I welcome you, welcome all parishioners and the guests and visitors joining us on this beautiful rainy day. God has blessed us in so many different ways. God's asking us to love Him back by loving our neighbor. Four times the moments we fail to do so, we ask for God's mercy. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We glorify you. have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. Almighty ever loving God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Thus says the Lord, you shall not molest or oppress an alien, for you were once aliens yourselves in the land of Egypt. You shall not wrong any widow or orphan. If ever you wrong them and they cry out to me, I will surely hear their cry. My wrath will flare up, and I will kill you with the sword. Then your own wives will be widows, and your children orphans. If you lend money to one of your poor neighbors among my people, you shall not act like an extortioner toward him by demanding interest from him. If you take your neighbor's cloak as a pledge, you shall return it to him before sunset. For this cloak of his is the only covering he has for his body. What else has he to sleep in? If he cries out to me, I will hear him, for I am compassionate. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I love you, Lord, my strength. I love you, Lord, my strength. I love you, O Lord, my strength. O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer. I love you, Lord, my strength. My God, my rock of refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Praise be the Lord, I exclaim, and I am safe from my enemies. I love you, Lord, my strength. The Lord lives, and blessed be my rock. Extolled be God, my Savior. You who gave great victories to your king and showed kindness to your anointed. I love you, Lord, my strength.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Sisters and brothers, you know what sort of people we were among you for your sake, and you became imitators of us and of the Lord. receiving the word in great affliction with joy from the Holy Spirit, so that you became a model for all the believers in Macedonia and in Achaia. For from you the word of the Lord has sounded forth, not only in Macedonia and in Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has gone forth, so that we have no need to say anything. For they themselves openly declare about us what sort of reception we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve the living and true God, and to wait his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who delivers us from the coming wrath. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Some of you may be aware, I just came back from a beautiful pilgrimage to the shrines of Italy, including audience with the Holy Father, the Pope. It was a group. Some people from our parishes here also went. It was all went very well, beautiful, and the audience, there was a general audience on St. Peter's Square. We were pretty close to Pope Francis, who drove by. So he sends his greetings to all of you, by extension, of course. And but he sat down and in his catechesis he talked about love for the neighbor. It kind of coincides with today's gospel reading and the first reading. By the time Jesus came to the scene 2,000 years ago, Jewish scholars, the rabbis, the scribes, those in the know, they kind of devised a system of interpretation of the Ten Commandments given, brought back by Moses from Mount Sinai, given to us by God. And there was 613 total of guidelines, interpretations, regulations, principles to follow. Some daily, some on seasonal basis, and people were kind of pretty confused. So no wonder they would ask, well, which one is the top one? Which one is there like a number one that really takes the cake? And Jesus answered back by saying, well, yes, the first one is the first commandment, love God. But then he added a description of particular way that we should love God. So he says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, And heart is not, he didn't mean the physical muscle that pumps blood, but the spiritual heart, the seat of our soul. That's where our free will dwells, and it's not in our brain. Brain is more like a computer, kind of receiving information and processing it. It's really in the heart. That's where we kind of meet God. Our conscience, that's in the heart. So with all your heart, with all your soul, the soul is the immortal part of us, body and soul. Soul is undying part, the indestructible part, everlasting, ever living. And so we're supposed to love God with all of our soul for eternity, because our bodies are not eternal. Our bodies are temporary, just to help connect with this world. But ultimately, we'll be loving our God with our soul forever in heaven in the new glorified bodies. And then he says, and with all your mind. Mind, that's the reason part. That's part of our soul, reason and free will. That's pretty much what soul consists of. That's what angels have. They have no bodies, but they have reason, intelligence, and free will. So we have it too in our soul. And so Jesus is asking us to, with all your mind, basically means, one, all the thoughts, all the intentions should be directed towards God, specifically towards doing God's will. Because a perfect way of loving God is by obeying and following and doing God's will in our lives. That's what Jesus did. That's what all the saints did. Jesus said a number of times that he did not come to do his own will, but to do his Father's will, Heavenly Father's will. And by giving us an example, and also encouragement to do the same. And all the saints, there's no other way to get to heaven but to become a saint. To become a saint, we have to do God's holy will in this life. That's the bottom line. Obviously not easy, because our ego kind of gets in the way. Our ego wants to have its own way. It's like, I'll do it my way, the famous Sinatra's song. Not God's way, but my way. And usually my way means, well, to kind of go on a sidetrack and lose a way, and then eventually trying to come back to God after realizing that my way is not working too well without following God's way. So with all your mind, St. Paul tells us in letter Corinthians, another reading, renew your minds. Always refresh your mind. Refresh your way of thinking. Change the way you're looking at things. That's what he means. Conversion. It's a renewing of our minds, because we are stuck in a pattern of thinking, a pattern of prejudices and judgment calls, and most of it on a subconscious level from our childhood, and we don't even know why we think the way we do. So it's good to renew our minds, kind of asking questions and seeking answers and gaining new perspective on life, on the world, and especially now when the world is changing so quickly. Our culture is this is like the fastest accelerated change happening in the history of the known civilization because of technology. And it's gonna only accelerate because of artificial intelligence. So the more important is for us to stay attached to spiritual side of life, to be attached to Jesus through sacraments and prayer, renew our minds. So that's our first commandment, love God with our whole essence of our being. And of course, if we do that, then it's gonna translate into our expression of our body, the way we do things and act out and so on. But really starts from the heart and from the mind. So And then he says the second commandment. He attaches the second commandment to the first one. And he says, well, love your neighbor as yourself. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. It's easy to say, I love God. It's hard to prove it, really, but the proof is in the pudding, and that's the proof is really how we deal with other people. Because Jesus makes the link, the connection. God is, we encounter God by encountering other people created in the image and likeness of God. Imperfect because of original sin, still, that's the way to encounter God, and we do so through the church, sacraments and church and dealing with people, gaining strength, inside wisdom to do it in the right way, with love and charity and compassion and forgiveness, all the things that God is showing us, we're supposed to show to other people. Love your neighbor. In the parable of the prodigal son, Jesus clearly indicated that who's our neighbor? Anyone who needs help. Doesn't have to belong to our tribe, our culture, our language. Anyone who needs help, especially someone who is in danger of death or serious danger, we should always try to help. So, but then Jesus says, as you love yourself, love your neighbor as you love yourself. That's oftentimes kind of forgotten part of it, not really discussed much. What does it mean to love ourselves? Well, it's hard to love others unless we love ourselves first, unless we accept the way we are, the way God made us, with limitations, challenges, maybe some struggles and bad habits, and that's who we are. As long as we own it and we bring it to God, we come to Sunday Mass, we bring gifts of bread and wine to the altar, so we can also touch ourselves to the gifts, and they come to the altar, and God is blessing, transforming the gifts that become. The bread and wine becomes body and blood, soul and divinity of Jesus, of himself. But also God is transforming us. If we ask, we come out different people. And more loving, more accepting, more forgiving. So if we love ourselves in a healthy way, not in some kind of a hedonistic or a selfish way, but in a healthy acceptance of our limitations, then it's easier for us to be less judgmental, more accepting of others, because nobody's perfect. And so that's the commandment, love God with our neighbor. A good reminder of it is the crucifix. There's two beams, the vertical one reminds us of our connection to God the Father. So I love God. And then horizontal one reminds us of the horizontal dimension of our lives, that's the church, the interaction with people. Jesus extended his hands on the cross, embracing all the people who've ever lived, asking them to come back into the kingdom because he loves us so much. So by extension, we're being invited to then, pass on this love from Jesus unto others, because the world today needs lots of love, especially we continue to pray for countries torn by divisions and conflicts and wars, Ukraine and now Israel. We need to pray for peace, peaceful resolution, stop of unnecessary bloodshed, killing women, children. It's not part of God's will. God's will is peace, love, and forgiveness. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. To him all men have been made, for us and for our salvation, came down from heaven,
and by the Holy Spirit,
incarnate the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake was crucified with Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven, and is seated on the right hand of the Father.
He will come again to judge the living and the dead. No end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who by our Mother and Son is adored and glorified,
who is
in process. I believe in one holy Catholic Church, for the forgiveness of sins, for the resurrection of the dead, and life of the world to come. Amen. People on the journey of faith, we present our prayers and petitions to our loving Heavenly Father. We trust that He will answer them according to His holy will.
Our response today is, let us pray to the Lord. That the church may be a model for the world in the way that we care for those in need through our time, talents, and treasure, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected officials, that they may pursue legislation and policies that reduce hunger, homelessness, unemployment, and poverty, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who work tirelessly for the benefit of those in need and give of their time and energy and spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace around the world, especially in the Middle East, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life, especially in the Diocese of Buffalo. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those struggling with illnesses and recovering from surgeries, especially Todd Blessing, Janice Sukowicki, Cindy Chapman, Jason Berry, Maureen Fronapple, Arlene Jenkins, that our Blessed Mother may comfort, console, and help them find inner joy amid their challenges, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, that the Good Shepherd may welcome them into the peace of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And especially today, for our friend Frank Larkin, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of us gathered here today, and for our prayers and intentions that we bring individually before the Lord, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, Lord, for calling us to be your disciples, for coming to us with your sacraments and all the graces we need to follow you daily. We ask you to help us today to always remain faithful to your covenant in doing your, fulfilling your commandments, especially the first one, by loving you and loving our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please join us in our hymn during the offertory, number 782, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman, number 782.
Hail Mary, quiet light. Morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother, peaceful dove.
Almighty Father,
may the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, and the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. And by his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, bread of life and a chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Michael our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Brendan's and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name,
thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth as in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant for peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
After each other, a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I will not that you should enter my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in our hymn during the communion, number 628, No Greater Love, number 628.
Father Chris. Blood of Christ, blood of Christ.
For those unable to attend Mass in person to receive the Eucharist, I invite you to pray an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
There is no greater love, says the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love than to lay love, no greater love than to lay down your life for a friend. It was not you who chose me, it was I who chose you to go forth and bear fruit. Your fruit must endure, so you will receive all you ask the Father in my name. There is no greater love, saith the Lord, than to lay down your life for a friend. There is no greater love, no greater love, than to lay down your life for a friend.
Turn over now in your books to number 695, Only This I Want. Number 695.
Sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Would you please be seated a few more moments? I have a special announcement from the bishop.
There's a statement relative to diocese's bankruptcy proceedings. The same statement is printed in the parish bulletin on page 3. So I'd like to encourage you to take a copy of it today if you want to read it in more details. So this is the statement from the bishop. For some time now, the diocese has been actively engaged in mediation with the creditors committee, which represents the interest of abuse survivors. The diocese's insurance carriers also have participated in mediation as we work to establish a pool of settlement funds to provide some measure of restitution and, we pray, closure for survivors. Any ultimate settlement will need to be funded by monetary contributions sourced from across our Catholic community, including from the diocese, parishes, and other affiliated Catholic entities, as well as from available insurance assets. While confidential settlement discussions continue, our Catholic community must remain steadfast in supporting survivors and dedicating available resources to their healing. To that end, the diocese, in close consultation with the priests who make up the parish steering committee, is making a commitment that the collective contribution of our Catholic community, not including any insurance monies, will be at least $100 million. We recognize that honoring this commitment will be challenging, but it is absolutely necessary that we do everything in our power to set things right, to move beyond this dark chapter in our history and move forward as together we work to rebuild and renew our church. We'll keep you posted as more information becomes available. It's a shocking number, no question, and I want to just clarify one thing from the statement here that may be a bit confusing. It says that Bishop consulted the priests who make up the parish steering committee. He doesn't imply any of our family parishes here. None of our priests were consulted, none of our parishes were consulted. So it's strictly some committee up, higher up at the diocesan level. The only thing I can do at the moment is to encourage you to keep the faith, keep the prayers going, because it's going to be painful. Each parish will be assessed a certain amount, and it's going to be a high amount. It's an evil that we have to endure, and hopefully kind of learn from it and make sure that it will never happen again. And it's a difficult thing, but as Bishop said, more information will be forthcoming. We don't know exact timeline or when it's going to come, within a year maybe, hopefully. So in the meantime, let's pray for the survivors, pray for everyone in need of special prayers. I'll be hearing confessions for just a few moments after this Mass, so if anyone is in need of confession, urgent, I'll be there for you.
And our closing hymn today, number 528, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee, number 528.
Depth of happy rest. I said he takes IV out.
Thank you.